Single, no feelings. It's coming out.
Hey, Scoop, go ask him to quiet it down for me. Because the mic's picking them up.
Yeah. 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 She was on the side, but now she on the team. We started out as friends, till I got in between. She liked the way I drip, I always make a scene. She in my top five, shorty on the team. Shorty in the whip, shorty on the team. Shorty by my side, shorty on the team. Shorty stay down, shorty on the team. She on the team. She said she got a boyfriend, he cutting the checks. She shining like a Bessie, I rock her like a Prezi. I pump it like a Getty, she riding like a Chevy. I'm in the friend zone, that's all I used to hear. I'm in the end zone, while she doing cheers. When she acting petty, I just make her disappear. Steph Curry, I'ma shoot my shot from anywhere. She was on the side, but now she on the team. We started out as friends, till I got in between. She liked the way I drip, I always make a scene. She in my top five, shorty on the team, yeah. Shorty in the whip, shorty on the team, yeah. Shorty by my side, shorty on the team, yeah. Shorty stay down, shorty on the team, yeah. She on the team, yeah, she on the team. We don't go out to movies, we don't go out to eat. We don't be out in public, we strictly under sheets. I rip and run the streets, but not everyone I meet gon' end up being team, some things I'll never speak. I know that she a freak, I never say a peep. We fly out to Miami, we party like the Greek. Rentals with heated seats, TV's a must at least. She like the role play, so it's like a meet and greet. Cherish the time we spend, we know how much it meant. You'll always be my friend, until we meet again. We blowing like the wind, we young and reckless and we living life of sin, let's do it all again. She was on the side, but now she on the team. We started out as friends, till I got in between. She like the way I drip, I always make a scene. She in my top five, shorty on the team, ay. Shorty in the whip, shorty on the team, yeah. Shorty by my side, shorty on the team, yeah. Shorty stay down, shorty on the team, yeah. She on the team, yeah. She was on the side, but now she on the team. We started out as friends, till I got in between. She like the way I drip, I always make a scene. She in my top five, shorty on the team. Shorty in the whip, shorty on the team, yeah. Shorty by my side, shorty on the team, yeah. Shorty stay down, shorty on the team, yeah. She on the team, yeah.
Where you get that beat from, too?
Yeah, hey, I appreciate that.
Where you get that beat from?
I believe his name was, I don't even remember. I ain't gonna hold you.
Bang it up, bro.
But it's original. Yeah, Factory. Hey, yo, listen, we starting a little late, but we getting toward this. The No Feelings Show.
No Feelings Show, you know we saying? Here.
Powered by Global Tunes Network, Philly Dot Hip Hop. What up, Sha, my engineer. I'm Uptown GR. I got my co-host.
Queen Love in the Queen building. Love. What's up?
And hey. we sitting here with Homie Ford and PNB Chairs, my guys.
Hey, we in the fucking building.
Oh, Lord, yeah. Wait, no cursing on this
one. Oh, dang.
Take care of yourself.
Oh, bad, y'all. Take care of yourself. Love. Excuse me.
No, but we good. We're going to jump right into it, man. Y'all guys been doing a lot, man. Y'all been around, man. So I got some questions that me and the Queen put together for y'all. You know what I'm saying?
Say less, say less.
How long y'all been doing music together? And how can our fans, you know, check out your music? Where can they find it at? How long y'all been doing music together?
We've been rapping together since what? 16, 17?
2007.
2007
to now. Right, we linked up. We linked up in high school. And then
right.
It was like we was linked ever since. And man, we started sliding everything together. He let us know when he had block parties. We go back his hood. My folks was from back his hood too already.
Okay.
And then when we had block parties, he was coming to our joint.
Right.
Homie used to be coming up there getting tore.
Yo, one of them. Go ahead, tell them the story.
Hey, yo, one block party we had, like it was our block party. So like any PNB block party, it was normally ran out of my crib.
You tell them so, like, what the PNB stand for. I'm from around the way, so I know, but a lot of people don't know.
Right. PNB stand for Pastorius and Baton. It's in Germantown. I mean, it's a cross street. All the young boys that know, as soon as stuff start popping, they used to be walking through with their cameras, recording they on the corner. We be in the cut just looking, cracking up. Like,
right.
It was always like everybody trying to make something happen musically, comically. We got comics, basketball players, all that type of stuff.
Right.
When Homie would come to the Jones, one of the block parties we had, I'm in the crib getting the drinks together, trying to get too many stragglers out my house.
Right.
And they like, yo, your man Homie out there stretched outside. I'm like, what you mean he stretched outside? Get out, this Max. Boy was fried, bro. He got so fried, he just laid down. Like, I think it was the sidewalk or something. I woke him up, I said, bro, you too fried. You can't carry on. Because I got to keep my eye on anything. Because R. Jones was always peace. Like, we never had fights or nothing at our block parties, bro. But it'd be packed. And it's always love. It'd be everybody from all over the city.
Right.
But we got non-tolerance for for the negativity up there, John, back then. You know what I mean?
Exactly.
When it started getting too positive negative up there, I stopped.
I've only been to one of those cookouts, but it was rolling when I was at that John.
Yeah, bro. That's the best thing about it, bro.
Yo, I was fried that night, though. Real rap. Like, I don't even know.
He said I was
on
fried
pills that night. That's when I was used to be taking pills.
Oh, that's what it was.
Oh, Jesus.
I'm like, woke up off the John. I'm like, I'm wrong. I walked the shame.
Oh, man. Hey, listen. Sometimes you get turned up. You know, it happens to the best of us.
Yeah, it was a good vibe.
We've been rocking good for vibe.
Hey, listen.
Matter of fact, that same block party, I came out the next morning. I went to go get a bun. When I came back to the house, Rock and his cousin Shotty was sleep on the same spot Homie was sleeping. on my ledge like this. I'm like, yo, what y'all doing, bro? Y'all cool? Like, ain't nobody go nowhere last night.
Right.
It was crazy. It was the punch. That punch was putting people under.
So I'm hearing that the block parties is where it's at.
Yeah, them joints was all that, bro.
Okay, can't wait till the summer again. So I can
shut them joints down a while
right
ago.
Right at Pastorius and Baton. You know
I shut them
Say it again, right away.
Pastorius and Baton.
Pastorius and Baton.
That's in Germantown.
Yeah.
And Pastorius and Baton. So that's what PNB means.
Yep. Pastorius and Baton.
PNB rock.
And it's crazy.
Right. And there's a lot of y'all because I hear PNB like
it's 11 rappers.
A lot of
11 rappers.
11 rappers. Yeah. Because somebody got subbed out. Somebody got subbed in. So it's 11. It's 11 rappers.
Okay. That's dope. That's super dope. So that's like a community thing.
Yeah, it was like just the neighborhood. Like everybody was, you know, I was like already chasing it. Like I had a super crazy fire in me. Like I had to make it happen because I didn't feel like we had nothing up there.
You gotta
like,
be
and that's how like when me and Homie first started rapping together, I had a joint. We started. It was me and my brothers. Same thing. Back then they called us Clutch Shooters, and I was like basically trying to bring DVDs uptown.
I remember that era.
Yeah, because I felt like. You know, like, no, it was never no shade, never no disrespect, but, you know, like, Headshots, they knew the North Philly rappers more. They knew the West Philly rappers more.
Yeah.
I'm like, damn, y'all only know Vodka and Cheek and then Quill. Everybody who hold it down for us got bars and y'all know it, so y'all should let everybody else shine. So I came up with Clutch Shooters, and I put everybody up there that I knew on there, and I still included them.
Right over there. He told me that. He told me the exact same thing you said right there.
And that I included them. Yeah.
My
Vodka.
It was Wham in Germantown.
Yeah.
I'm saying everybody had a Clutch Shooter hoodie in Germantown.
Real rare. You know what I'm saying? We was running around with that joint going hard, and my whole thing was just to... Because Young Bob tried to get me on Headshots, and I was like, I could do that. But when I got home from him offering it to me, he's like, just go on, call me when you get back up your way or whatever.
Right.
As soon as I got to my block, it was this boy named Rizzy the Trap Boy from Haines Street. And Jay Ryder used to live up there too, the boy Jay Ryder.
Yeah.
He lived right on top of Hogan and Morton. And when I got up there, I remember everybody saying, like, yo, you about to get a branch on Headshots? Like, it's gonna be popping. We gonna have everybody on it. It wasn't a branch. They was just saying me. That's why I just was like, no, you know what? We gonna start our own joint. Everybody like, man, you tripping, bro? Like, you supposed to go with Bob? Like, you tripping? But Clutch, we just started whamming. Like, and we all got our names out there off of that. Like,
right.
We ain't had no name for that.
Tell us about this. Y'all got something going on with His and Hers. Tell me everything about that, cause. You know, people tuning in, they might want to, you know what I'm saying, come out and show love.
Yes, we need to promote.
That's all we about on the No Feelings Show.
Oh, yeah, hell yeah.
It's called the No Feelings Show because there's no feelings towards negativity. So we showing love to everybody.
Everybody getting love.
Right, yeah.
Everybody getting love.
That's how I am.
Y'all hungry, let's go.
Every first Tuesday of every month.
Every first Tuesday of every month.
Yeah.
So this upcoming December 3rd.
Yeah.
And so what y'all do? Y'all have people perform, or how y'all do it?
The last time, you know what I'm saying, that was our first joint.
Yeah.
I mean, we had Sammy come out and do the podcast, you know what I'm saying?
Shout out to Sammy.
They was interviewing artists after they performed,
before they performed. That's dope.
It was a good look, you know what I'm saying? We just trying to really change the game with it.
Yeah.
Make sure that artists eat, you know what I'm saying? So we just trying to set it up there. The artists will want to sell tickets because they're getting a profit.
Yeah. I like what y'all doing. That's dope, man.
That's cool.
It's the same thing like what we were just talking about, like with the Clutch and stuff. Like, it's like everybody not getting the type of Philly. Everybody act crazy, bro. Philly, we got the best talent. I don't care how you want to look at it, how you want to think about it, what you hoping, what you wishing, bro. This is where it's at. Like, this is really where it's like. It's like, it's here, dog. I don't care what anybody else want to look at, think at, hope. Like, I done run around and I seen it. Yeah, it's so much talent here. It don't make any sense, man. Just like that Childish Gambino video, the cartoon joint he got. The boy who did that video was from Philly, cuz I never knew that.
Never knew that.
Boy named Justin Roche or something like that. Yo, he on the gram. Okay. And I think he do something with the Boondocks cartoons. Like,
shout
I think that's
you.
Him. Boondocks? Yeah, I think he do like some of the art in that. Like, it's so
that's
much stuff.
Dope,
Andre 3000 live downtown right now. He been here for like 2 months.
I heard that.
Like, nobody pay attention to the city.
Right.
Everybody be running everywhere else, but it's really here. And it's like the thing that's destroyed with it is you can't go nowhere and get paid for your music, bro. Like, in the city.
Right.
You go to Atlanta, I was down there, I seen it. You know what I mean? Them dudes, they got shows that they be having. Them dudes making $5,000, $6,000.
Yeah.
They don't got no name. They just got their neighborhood.
Right.
But they understand, like, they going in there to put money in your pocket. You entertaining them, but they put money in your pocket to take it to another city and do it, basically. You get what I'm saying? It's your budget, because that's what you're going to make off of it. So, like, with the event we having, it's $20 to get in. You get half of everything that come in, which on your name. There's a list at the door. Every artist that you coming to see, you write your name next to the artist you coming to see. As many heads as we count up at the end of the night, you get $10 off of each head.
Wow.
You feel me? As an artist.
I'm down.
Yeah, we put you right on the list, bro. Bro, listen, bro, we'll put you on the list. This is how thorough it is, bro. We'll put you on the list. And even if, because we're doing three artists at each event, we ain't gonna never oversaturate it. I feel like it's gonna make it feel more like a concert, bro. That's what they do in Atlanta. They'll keep on making people perform. You start knowing the song, you start coming. You feel what I'm saying? Listen, even if you're not performing and you coming and we put you on the list, anybody who come and say, man, I came here because of Gio, I'm gonna give you $10 off of each head. You feel me? That's the whole point of it, bro. Anybody that's a part of it, that's with us, that's gonna push with us, we're breaking you down. Ain't no need
to
nobody trying to get fat off of it. We really just trying to break through with it.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Open it up. Yeah, no,
it ain't no favorites. We pick none of that. It's whoever involved. We give everybody a month. Every three artists a month, and we listen to all the songs. We even listen to the songs and think, all right, yo, maybe you should perform it to this person because the way this sound, I'm going through everything.
Wow.
Like, you feel me? Like, we ain't.
I hope y'all hear that out there. Like, this is the movement.
This is going to be a movement.
Y'all going to do some big things because people really going to come to y'all.
Shout out to Shusky.
All y'all artists.
Yeah,
Shusky.
Shusky Raw. I don't care how many times we talk about this event. We got to bring up Shusky because he was the first person that did this. Me and Hami did a performance with him. And one day we looked up. We had $200 in our pocket off of a performance with him. Random night, bro. Like, he gave us half of all our guests that came for us. I said, what? We leaving out that joint. Everything we needed to get done, we was getting done.
I had a good night in that joint.
What?
One time. I had the whole joint in there. That joint was Tommy.
Listen, we're going to go to a song break real quick. Shout Money. We're going to go into that positive puff.
Hey.
Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And we're going to come right back and have more with Tommy Ford and PNB Chiz.
Yes, sure that. Yes, yes,
I ain't cursed, right? We're
going to go into Live My Life.
Okay.
Yeah.
I ain't did no cursing.
What's that?
You only get one life.
Young and good.
Living reckless.
Gotta live it right.
Shit, crazy. Let's get it. I'm trying to live my life. 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 We gotta stop killing each other. I'm trying to live my life. Shoulders, my back ache. Before you talk down on me to somebody, get your facts straight. Everything I do for a reason. Switch whips like every season. Niggas try to kill me twice. I'm just thankful I'm still breathing. Put your mind to it and believe it. You'll get to it, you'll achieve it. Yeah, I try to leave the drugs alone. I'm still fighting off these demons. All these young boys keep scheming. Pro meth, I keep leaning. All these bodies keep dropping. And they souls just keep leaving. I had enough of this shit. My young boys out here stuck on the strip. My sons don't play with the guns, but still I got one that's sucked in the whip. I had enough of this shit. My young boy out here stuck on the strip. I'm telling my sons don't play with the guns, but still I got one that's stuck in the whip. I'm trying to live my life. 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 We gotta stop killing each other. I'm trying to live my life. Solution. I swear if I make it, I'm taking my family and we going far away. If I'ma do it, then I'ma go hard, I'm going in all the way. I just wanna celebrate every day like it's a holiday. Like boys in the hood, I lost my homie in the driveway. Niggas moving funny, but that's not how I ride. Just wait till I come up, they gon' switch sides. Keep the negative energy off of my life. All I wanna see is those flames in them heart eyes. Struggle that's trying to survive. In this crazy world, I'm just trying to stay alive. I'm trying to live my life. 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 We gotta stop killing each other. I'm trying to live my life. We gotta do way better. I'm trying to live my life. I don't even want no smoke. I'm trying to live my life.
Even if they thought, like, Biggie probably knew he was better than everybody that was in New York at the time. But I'm going in with y'all, because I'd rather y'all be my competition than somebody that pop up out of Atlanta I never heard of and really bomb me. You feel me? Like, that's how he was. So even if it's some conniving stuff going on with people behind the scenes in Philly, it's like, we ain't even got a structure. And we don't even got a structure. Y'all just sneaking each other and we ain't got nothing yet. Like, it's just, I'm going to sneak this ball, I'm going to sneak this ball, I'm going to sneak this ball to get to hip hop since 1987. Like,
We busting it up.
In paradise and my brother. Yeah, like, you know.
So, I got a couple questions. I need to know what producers y'all work with, like what people y'all work with. Let us know Our songs is out right now. Where it's at.
Pete Man.
Oh yeah, Pete Man for sure. Dreas Major.
Yeah.
Dreas Major.
Dreas, your cousin.
Oh yeah, shout out to Nub.
Shout out to Nub.
I
Nub is doing crazy.
Yeah, so that's what we all about, love. So
Joy Futuristic. Joy Futuristic for sure.
Yeah, we want y'all to shout out everybody y'all with because it's all love, you know.
Joy Futuristic, Go Grizzly.
Go Grizzly. Shout out Buddha the Future.
Buddha the Future out in New York.
Shout out to them folks.
See, this joint, I don't like it. I can't see that in the background.
What y'all got out right now? Where is it at? Where can we listen to it at? What y'all got out right now?
We got stuff on every platform.
Yeah, that's a banger.
Mm-hmm. On iTunes. Tidal. Spotify.
Mm-hmm. Amazon Prime. Xbox. Yes, PlayStation. Yes.
So y'all hear it. You can go anywhere.
YouTube. Right. Yeah, we on all media platforms.
Anywhere that music can be streamed.
We on everything.
What songs I got out right now? What's,
that's what I'm talking about.
I got Take It. Respect This. I got a couple singles by myself. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? But as far as me and Chiz catalog, We got enough for a tape. We talked about it, but
yeah.
We ain't never lock in on it yet. You know
we
how
keep
that
on going back and forth with the names.
Right.
Like we got certain stuff. We into a lot of the same stuff. Like
You know, we into like Dragon Ball Z and all of that.
Hell yeah.
You know how Wu Tang brought that to the, you know what I'm saying, that martial arts.
Yeah, that martial arts. It's the same thing. It's the same thing.
Because I got 90s nostalgia. I'm stuck in the 90s. I can't even help it. You know what I'm saying? I don't even care. You feel me?
That's
everything going in a circle anyway.
Yes, it do. And it come right back.
In the 90s was lit anyway. You can't tell me nothing different. You feel me? So that's what we're trying to bring back.
Half of the stuff people doing now is like recarved from back then. So
yeah, they dressing like Prince and all of that. You know what I'm saying? Again, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it's back there right now.
Yeah, and they like sampling a lot of the music back in the day too. Yeah.
I mean that happens, period. That was happening in the 90s too.
That's
some of our favorite Jones was samples. Especially all Biggie Jones.
Right.
I mean like Puff and all that. That's all he did was sample.
Yeah.
Feel me? Juicy was a crazy sample.
Yeah. That's what hip hop is. That's what hip hop is.
It's a legendary Jones.
Exactly.
Right.
So y'all got any videos out right now?
And that's what's going on right now.
We got videos. Damn, what was the name of the joint? I got a joint called Nowadays. That's the song
that's
just out.
That's
the song I just got. The latest video I got is Guilty by Association.
Guilty by Association.
I think that's the latest joint. Guilty by Association.
Shot by Scene Vision.
Yeah,
shout
sure,
out to
sure.
Scene Vision. He shot that
Scene
joint.
Visions, yep. Shout out to Scene Visions,
shout
my
out
dog.
Scene Visions. What's
Scene
up?
Scene Visions.
Scene Vision.
Yeah,
that's his joint. Yeah, shout out to him.
That was a good joint.
He hold us down. He rock with his heavy. Besides that, it's a lot of videos.
We holding on to a lot of stuff. I know that I ain't even got a video out right now. So, yeah, that's crazy. But we shooting.
Yeah, he crazy with that, man. I've been trying to get this boy.
See, I'm a perfectionist. I got to make sure.
Yeah, so I don't blame him. I like that, though.
Every time I hear something, you get what I'm saying, that's good to me. And what I'm doing, I always take it and be like, all right, so if I'm about to make a move and then somebody in the industry might hear a word about something, I should go a different way and do it this way.
Yeah.
You feel me? Like I was about to drop a tape named December. You know what I'm saying? In December. A lot of stuff crazy happened to me in my life in December. You know what I'm saying? Good or bad. You feel me?
That's deep.
Like I caught my first I caught my felony in December, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
My birthday in December. I was born on my aunt. We got the same birthday, you know what I'm saying? It's just a lot of stuff with December, so I was going to name it December. You know what I'm saying? But now I heard they ain't the way to go. You know what I'm saying? I got to focus on the single.
I like that too.
So what's the single?
The single is called 90s Love. That's the first one that I'm going to drop. I got Diamonds and Glitter out right now, too. That's Chiz's favorite joint.
Yeah.
But I like 90s Love.
Diamonds and Glitter
saying?
Crazy.
Diamonds and Glitter.
That
joint good,
it's definitely
too.
For the girls.
That Diamonds and Glitter is basically about, you know what I'm saying, messing around with them glitters. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Glitters. What do
they
mean?
Sure.
Yeah,
explain
what you mean
that.
By that? Yeah,
right,
what you mean
explain
by
that them glitters. What's that?
Messing around with that glitter. When you should have been focused on the diamond. You ain't going to find nothing in that glitter.
Factory.
Okay, so I like that.
What you mean?
Glitter. Hold up. Wait.
I know. I lost diamonds playing in glitter.
Right.
I'm still shining. I'm that. That's a good joint, though. It's
my favorite joint by him.
I'm definitely going to check that out.
Yeah, that's a good joint. That's everywhere. That's on. Yeah, Diamonds and Glitter. You can find that on iTunes and Tidal and Spotify and Sound.
Okay.
I think it's on Sound. It's on YouTube for sure.
Yeah, that's another thing about me. Like, I got like a just like I love music. Like, I love like being a part of like music. You know what I'm saying? Like, when it's coming up, like, I could tell like I could tell it was good. Like, I don't know, I got like an ear for it. You feel me?
Right.
And that's the thing with Hami. Like, I always knew it's like you can see. I see it at raw form more than I see it when it's polished. Like, I take pride in that. Like, I'd rather see it in raw form than when it's polished. Because when you can deal with something when it's in raw form, then you can watch it turn into what it's supposed to be. Like, you can actually help it turn into what it's supposed to be without it going through the headaches that will make you not want to do it. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's how I looked at it. Everything that I did, I look at it like, yo, I would do it. Whatever I got to do to make sure nobody got to go through this. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm talking about half of this stuff. Like, I was homeless at one point in time. I was watching an interview by the baby. It made me bang with him even more when he be talking about he lost everything he had before stuff took off. Like, that's exactly what happened before.
Sometimes you got to push the bar.
Like, everything. Everything, yo. Everything, yo.
Jules,
I'm telling you, like, homie, we used to argue about it all the time, and I try to tell this boy, like, he got to act for, like, female tracks. You know how I'd be like certain people that's real crazy with talking about girls?
Either way.
Fat Joe John and Nicki John that they just put up.
Me, I didn't even like my verse on that John, man. I didn't even like my verse on that John.
No, listen, I love
it. Wasn't polished.
It wasn't right.
No. I'm talking about my delivery. It wasn't nothing to do with nothing. It was me. I ain't like that. You know what I'm saying? Even though I got that unorthodox.
I got
you know what I'm saying? Whatever. Sometimes I come off like that, but that joint wasn't.
Sos
that
I got
wasn't
here.
Sos put a touch up on it. Shout out to Sos.
He did. No, Sos did his thing. Sos did his thing. That's what I'm saying. I'm a perfectionist. That's why I ain't dropped the joint yet. Now I'm going to put somebody on the 90s love hook. The song done. I done heard it 100 times.
Oh, yeah,
I'm 90 like,
loves
no.
A banger.
I'm like, no, now that joint need a... Now that joint need a few. We about to
transition
say
into the... Heartless cast, we got the whole cast in the building.
Hey, you already know.
And then we're gonna bring PNB Chiz and Hami Ford back.
Shout out to Philly Wonder Woman. Shout out my man Sandman. Shout out the whole cast on Heartless.
Oh, for sure that. Definitely shout out Sam, man.
Yeah, we about to get right into them.
So, Shy.
Don't go nowhere. We're gonna come right back to
you. Yeah, we'll be right. We're gonna pay some bills. You know what I mean? Hey, Shy, let them hear that single. She on the team.
Hey.
Yeah. She was on the side, but now she on the team. We started out as friends, till I got in between. She liked the way I drip, I always make a scene. She in my top five, shorty on the team. Shorty in the whip, shorty on the team. Shorty by my side, shorty on the team. Shorty stay down. She on the team, she on the team. Rosé in the glass, Deuce on the table. Friends with benefits, but we don't do no labels. I used to run into her and speak out of respect. Now when we see each other, it ain't nothing but sex. She told me not to call her phone, just send her a text. She said she got a boyfriend, he cutting the checks. She shining like a Bezzy, I rock her like a Prezi. I pump it like a Getty, she riding like a Chevy. I'm in the friend zone, that's all I used to hear. I'm in the end zone, while she doing cheers. When she acting petty, I just make her disappear. Steph Curry, I'ma shoot my shot from anywhere. She was on the side, but now she on the team. We started out as friends, till I got in between. She liked the way I drip, I always make a scene. She in my top five, shorty on the team. Shorty in the whip, shorty on the team. Shorty by my side, shorty on the team. Shorty stay down, shorty on the team. She on the team, she on the team. We don't go out to movies, we don't go out to eat. We don't be out in public, we strictly on the sheets. I rip and run the streets, but not everyone I meet. Gonna end up being team, some things I'll never speak. I know that she a freak, I never say a peep. We fly out to Miami, we party like the Greek. Rentals with heated seats, TV's a must at least. She like the role play, so it's like a meet and greet. Cherish the time we spend, we know how much it meant. You'll always be my friend, until we meet again. We blowing like the
sin. We live a life of sin. Let's do it all again. She was on the side, but now she on the team. We started out as friends, till I got in between. She liked the way I drip, I always make a scene. She in my top five, shorty on the team. Shorty in the whip, shorty on the team. Shorty by my side, oh, shorty on the team. Shorty stay down, shorty on the team. She on the team, yeah, she on the team. She was on the side, but now she on the team. We started out as friends, till I got in between. She like the way I drip, I always make a scene. She in my top five, shorty on the team. Shorty in the whip, shorty on the team, yeah. Shorty by my side, oh, shorty on the team, yeah. Shorty stay down, shorty on the team, yeah. She on the team, yeah.
You know what I mean?
We back.
We got the whole cast of the Heartless movie. It's coming out December 5th.
Told them.
You know what I mean? So we got the whole cast in the building. We got a bunch of actors in the building. We got the director, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah. Yes, in the building. What's your name, bro?
Jermaine Quick.
JQ in the building.
Yeah.
Sam,
how you doing? You
know what I mean?
What's up, bro?
My guy.
Uptown.
You know what I mean? We in the building. Shout out to y'all.
Hey.
I don't
Philly
know
Philly Wonder Woman in the building.
We got the Bible Princess in the building.
Hey, Bible hey, Princess Philly Wonder also Woman. The Bible. Hey. She got many titles. Philly many Wonder hats. Yeah. Many hats.
Comedian Kev G.
My guy Kev.
Hey.
Let's go.
Fucking shit. You already
right.
fucking know.
Oh, listen. We ain't cursing on this.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Take care of yourself. Take care of yourself.
I'm sorry.
No, we good, though. That's his joint.
That's my joint right there. You already know.
We got Megan
the Stallion. No, we got Megan.
Listen, we got Queens in the building, okay? It's Queens
right,
in
right.
the building.
Shout out to you. Yeah, thank you.
Main Gully.
Main Gully
in the building. Main
Gully
in the building.
Hey.
Gutter in the building. Okay. Bolo.
Bolo
in the building. Shout out to Bolo.
What's up? You can come in too. We want to see you too.
You say Capo?
Everybody in here.
You look like my man Odie Capo.
We got one of the main stars
on the phone right now. Nina,
oh, we got him on the line?
Yeah.
Nina.
Say what's up,
Nina. Hey. That's what's up. She on the phone. Yes.
Hang up and call her on Instagram phone. You can see her face.
That's wonderful.
Yeah.
I don't know if she can do that.
She got it.
She can do it.
You got Instagram face?
We are. Okay.
So, look, I got a question for y'all, right? How long were y'all filming the movie? And did y'all do a casting call for the actors, or was it like set in stone who y'all wanted to play certain parts?
Anytime I do a film, I don't do a casting call.
Facts.
I know exactly what I want to pick. I know exactly who I want to choose.
Right.
And I know exactly how to write it to that, cater to that person.
That's dope.
So basically, because when I used to do a casting call, you kind of get a lot of divas. You get a lot of different people that really don't understand the business and they think they know the business.
Right.
So I'd rather work with people that respect.
That's dope that you got a lot of people around you that you can, you know what I mean, put that together with.
Well,
yeah.
This is our fifth film. This is nothing new for me.
Oh,
okay.
Tell us about it.
Y'all homework, but
tell us about it. Go ahead. No. School us. Tell us about it.
I've reinvented myself like three times already. I mean, we started off with the DZE magazine. Illegal Styles is the brand.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And from that point, from the DVD magazines, I decided to do films in 2007.
Okay.
So I've been in the game since I was 15, you know what I'm saying? So musically, we started off with the music because I went to school for that.
Okay.
And then from that point on, I said to myself that I needed to really just gravitate to getting all artists together. See, the thing about my films, I use artists, comedians, and actors that normally wouldn't come together.
Right.
You know what I'm saying to you? And so at the end of the day, I found my niche in Philly to get artists to collab. And movies is the only thing that I knew that could do that. Because you got to understand that in our city, everybody say, go for self.
Right.
Speak.
But with movies, and they trust my vision, we all in it together.
Right.
And this is what you get out of it.
So
we five,
be,
like
yeah.
I said, we got five. We five films in, and my last film was not only nominated for the New York Harlem Film Festival, but it was on Fox 29 News, American Bully. It is now aired on Amazon Prime.
I'm familiar with that. Yeah.
We are the only independent film besides Meek Mills and from Philly on Amazon Prime.
Facts. Fact.
So that's
congratulations.
That's heavyweight.
That is big. Congratulations to all of y'all.
So this movie right here, it's not even been seen yet, but we got nominated for the Los Angeles Film Festival last week. And so that's going down. And we just got two writers.
Talk heavy.
I'm loving it. I'm a humble dude. I'm not really into that.
You see,
I mean?
I'm stuck right now.
I'm in my lane.
I like your vibe though.
You know what I'm saying? I'm in my lane, and I'm doing what I believe that's going to help the city. You feel what I'm saying?
Should. So focus.
Heartless is about mental illness and domestic violence seen through the eyes of a child.
Yes.
So it's about a young female named Kamira Barnes, the young lady you see on the flyer, and her mom, which is played by Lucinda Trotter. Is suffering from depression and alcoholism. And so she's really basically ignoring her daughter and is forcing her daughter to learn life through social media. So therefore, you get the movie Heartless. The little girl's watching this Heartless movie about all these different things that's going on. Yeah. And the star actor, Nina Pico, she's suffering from PTSD and depression. And she has a bunch of girlfriends that's around her. And so it's different stories. When you watch the movie, it's so much to go through. It's so much. Wow. But the movie questions how we allow our children to see what we're going through and what we're doing. And because you got to remember, what they learn today is what they become tomorrow.
Talk.
Right.
And so
he's dropping jewels. I hope y'all hear this.
These are the type of movies that I like to create, movies that really touch the spirit. You know what I'm saying?
So, right.
But we do have the shoot 'em up, bang, bang. We still got the drama.
Okay,
you know what I'm saying?
That's what makes
That's what makes a good film. But at the end of the day, I had to have some consciousness in the film.
The
structure, I just can't do it.
Stay woke. Yeah. I'm loving this. And you're talking about things that's important. These things have to be talked about. Depression is real.
Yeah, mental illness is real. 16.6 million people in America alone suffer from depression.
Yes.
Whether it's police, whether it's just the regular Joe. And police officers don't know how to handle people that have mental illness. Because I work at the forensic unit in Norristown State Hospital. So I see people young from 19 on up coming down there. And I'm hearing their stories and I'm learning exactly what's going on. So it was easy for me to write this film because I'm directly connected to it. You know what I'm saying? And I just want to see people being more aware of what mental illness is, you know what I'm saying?
I'm loving it.
And but also,
is it based on a true story?
It's based on true stories.
Okay. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying to you? Different things and different patterns that I ran into in my life, and that's around me.
Yeah.
And so, you know, like I said, I try to dig into the consciousness to make this, let people see that at the end of the day, we don't have to make the same crime story drama movies. It don't have to necessarily be the drug dealer that got up, was down on his luck, got up, and then all of a sudden everybody chasing him.
It don't have to be that.
You know what I'm saying? But we talking about some real issues.
That's
definitely touch people and be legacy. Most of my movies, I'm thinking legacy more so than anything else. I mean, our last movie, American Bully, touched on bullying, which is a major issue.
That needs to be touched on.
Right. So we did that. So, you know, in each one of my films, like I said, this is this movie right here is actually a continuation from our second film, which was Concealed Habitat. Sandman was in that as well. And so what that movie was based off of this one. So when you see this movie, it's a lot to talk about, like I said, and I don't want to take everybody else's time. I want everybody else to get some shine. But these movies, what I'm trying to do is link them together. So when you go back and look at my catalog of work.
Right.
They'll relate to each other and you'll have an understanding what the issues was that I was really talking about in our community.
Right.
And these
are
legacy issues because they still happen today. I mean, 10 years ago we did Concealed Habitat. 9 years ago. But it's still relevant now.
It's still relevant. Yeah, exactly.
You know, so at the end of the day, like I said, I love working with people. I'm in my lane though. You feel what I'm saying to you? And I'm comfortable with that. The only time I can get out of my lane is if Sam be like, yo, man, you gotta do this. And I'm like, oh, I don't know about that, bro. But, you know, he usually work it out. We kind of make it happen. But at the end of the day, I still try to stay conscious. If they don't have a conscious message, I can't do it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying to you? So at the end of the day, that's what I'm really all about.
Yeah.
We leveling up, man. You know what I mean? You can't continue to do films and not level up. But I don't see nobody in my lane right now.
That's factory.
And I'm
speaking. That's how I feel about the podcast. Because, listen, I don't do cursing on my podcast. I just started this. I never planned to have a podcast. My man Big 40, shout out to Kev Dub, Philly.hip-hop. He just came at me. He was like, oh, you do a podcast. I got the Joan down there. I'm like, all right, let's do it.
Right.
But I also know people that work for iHeartRadio that's up high. So I knew him for years. We got a relationship. I'm always at the Powerhouse every year, backstage, passes and all that. So this guy really likes me. And He said, you do a good job on this podcast, no cursing and all that. We can set a meeting up. That's all I need to do is to get in the door to set a meeting up. So this is what I'm doing. I started the podcast. This is what? Episode 5. By episode 2, the rest of the year is locked in with guests coming on the show. That's facts. Yes.
We appreciate
y'all.
For real.
And
real.
I
thank you.
Wow. You know, we grew up together, bro. I know you from.
And I appreciate Sandman for the idea. Cause
yes, cause y'all promote us. I was asking my bro
to come in and do an interview. He said, you know what? We're going to bring the whole cast in. I'm doing a movie. The movie coming in. Boom. That, why not? I'm all about showing love to everybody.
Exactly. Right.
You know what I mean?
Especially for the ones that just started, not nobody that already got a buzz. Exactly. You know what I mean? It's not all about catching them. Some people be wanting the ones that's already catching buzz. But I like the people like Sandman that don't got the buzz, but got it. You just got to do this. And I see it. But he trying and he ain't get there yet. But I want him to get there. Not the person that already got the K followers. They already got people that's already talking to them about anything they can get into to make them be live and make them be popular or richer.
You're saying just basically believing in raw talent.
Yeah, right. Exactly, raw talent. Exactly. Yeah. Like I'm comedy and I grew up on Martin and shows and funny and being goofy. Yeah. And that's what I love to do is be funny and make people laugh. And if I can make people laugh and be a star, I swear to God, I will do whatever I got to do because that's what I want to go for. People might not believe you. Like I tell my grandma, I tell my girl, I sit there, I talk around people that I know that love me that's here, but they just sit there. I'm not saying they don't care, but they sit there and just be normal. Nothing wrong with it. I'm not coming at them about it, but if they really believe in me and they really see that, they can really think like, yeah, you're right. Instead of saying, yeah, I believe you. I know you are. But is this the way you look and how I explain it to you? You just sitting there like it's a regular combo. Like I'm just telling you about somebody at school or something. No, this is something that I'm talking about my dream here. Like I'm
that
starting. Met people. And it's about connection.
I'm not saying that they don't care, but a lot of people really don't care. They just like,
They don't have no belief in you. But that's okay, because we believe in all of y'all. I'll tell you right now. I feel the energy in here. The energy is crazy in here.
I feel like sometimes when you got a dream, right?
Y'all gonna make it.
And your dream is big. If it's not a person's, if it's not another person, if like if it's not my dream, it's very hard for me to conceive this big ass. That shit is like life changing. Pardon me, I'm sorry.
You good, bro?
It's like life changing. Like when a person, you be like, yo, I remember when I first heard somebody get a record deal. I remember somebody told me I was gonna get a record deal. I looked at them like they was crazy. You know what I mean? Because it don't sound like it's for real. So don't think they don't support you. It's just lofty to them. Like it's very, very big. Like, damn, this boy say he gonna be the next Mark. That's hard for somebody to conceive, but it's up to you to convince them.
Right.
You understand what I'm saying?
But little do people know, like
people can't see it. If you can't grab it, most people, if you can't grab it, they don't see it. They don't believe in it. It gotta be like they right there in front of their face for them. You know what I mean? To understand. You can't grab it, it ain't real. But it's your vision. Right. It's real.
It's your vision.
You got to use all that as motivation.
Because they can't see.
I just feel like they believe in me, but I feel like they just got to understand that right now, the way I'm feeling inside my bones and my skin, I cry. When I could watch a story about Biggie and about how Diddy came back off of Biggie dying, that made me cry because he really lost his artist. And he was lost without Biggie. Mm-hmm. And when I seen it and I was sitting in the crib, I'm watching it, and he got back out and he started doing everything like, he started going in. Then he started making All About the Benjamins. He started going in. Next thing you know, he started making people want to do what he do. And he did it. You understand? No matter if it was the shiny suits, no matter what he did, because people try to play that. But he still made it and people still loved it. Mm-hmm. And I just feel like I can make it. I feel like I can make my dream come true. And I mean,
that's all that matters. As long as you believe in it.
It's a lot of positive energy. Mm-hmm. All you gotta do is be positive and strategize and keep doing what you're doing, bro. Don't let the negativity affect you.
Mm-hmm. Let me tell you, this is what this movie does. So at the end of the day, like I said, for the 5 films that we did, I've took an underground artist. I mean, I started off with Spank and Young Hot. Rise Like Cream, that was the first flick we did. Okay. The second film we had C Knowledge from Diggable Plans.
Yeah,
world Grammy winning C Knowledge.
Right.
Third film, we still used artists from the city that was hot in their own perspective.
Right.
Fourth movie, we did the same thing, and now we're here, and you see the cast I'm working with, but this ain't even all the cast. We got 40 members.
Yeah, we
got Ace McCloud. Spokesman on board. Son One is in the building.
You know what I'm saying? That's my guy.
We got Molly Cobain. You know what I'm saying to you? So all of these artists would have never came together.
Yeah.
Right. You feel what I'm saying to you?
Right.
But we found a conduit to make all of that happen.
Yeah.
And this is the reason why you feel this energy, because it's meant to be.
Right.
We supposed to be here. It ain't no mystery about the situation.
Right.
Everything that's happening right now kinetically is supposed to be here. That's the kind of energy we deal with. You feel what I'm saying to you? So we love you. You know what I'm saying? And in that love that you feel, that's what you're feeling.
I'm telling you, it's crazy. Like, everybody in this room,
didn't tell me no. They could have said no. They looked at it, they was like, yo, I'm down. So that's that love. And once you feel that initial love, you ain't got to worry about shooting a film. The film going to shoot itself.
Right.
Right.
You feel what I'm saying to you? I didn't have difficulties on that level. You know what I'm saying? At first, trying to get everybody scheduled together and get everybody
of course,
on time.
Of course.
You know, we always on black man
time. We always on black man time.
But for the most of it, when I'm saying there's no problem, like, once I tell them what I need, they on it. Like, she came on board, I told her she got to get punched in the mouth. She didn't say no.
She got punched in the mouth?
I'm sleeping in punched in the mouth.
You know, oh, I got to watch that.
I get punched in the mouth for free.
Listen, what I'm saying to you, a lot of people don't want to take certain roles because they don't want to look like the
like, honestly,
when you do acting, it's a whole different lane. You got to be willing to open up.
For sure. Like, I'm not no killer.
Oh, here we go. Dropping jewels.
That's what I did.
Listen. My cousin came on board.
I questioned him like, man, you going to really...
I killed him.
You going to make that happen to me like...
Right off the bat. I killed him.
You know what I mean? You know, like,
kill me.
That's
how you
do it. That's what it is.
But he came in.
But it's love that...
Right.
You got people that's accepting these roles. That's what, you know what I mean?
Because you believe in them. I think that's what y'all need to know, that he believed in y'all, and he know y'all going to make moves. Sure. That's what's up.
Yeah.
Like, I can't.
To make the visit.
That energy is crazy.
Y'all see the bigger picture, and that's what it's about.
I came in to learn from him. Mm-hmm. I was writing my own screenplay, and I wanted to see it on a different level. So that's why I came in. I wanted to see how he produced and directed movies. And so any role he gave me, I would have taken. That's just wonderful. To see how this is done.
Exactly.
And on a different level.
Exactly.
So, and it's good to support Philly, period.
Yes, Philly support Philly. I've been saying it every show.
Right.
Philly support Philly.
For sure.
And I'm supporting y'all. I am going to the movie. I will be there. I'm bringing my whole family.
I appreciate
that. I'm bringing the whole family, okay?
I want you to enjoy yourself.
I'm bringing the team.
But you got to remember, I don't do those regular jeans. This ain't no regular degular.
Right.
You got to dress up.
Okay.
Oh, you know my name, right? I'm the queen. Oh, I'm dressing up.
Yeah. Red carpet,
I'm dressing up.
BET style, we're doing that. You know
yes,
what I mean?
Yes.
Because if you come with the attitude,
right,
that's
how I want to come.
That's what it's going to be.
Listen.
Exactly.
I know. You are what you think you are and what you who you are.
Exactly.
Look, I know I'm a star in my body.
You know what I mean?
I know I'm a star in my body.
Yo, but before we do anything, I definitely, you got to bring Maine in them and listen, man.
Yes, come on.
Hey, what's up, podcast?
They came in off the dolo on the movie,
right?
Because Sam said, yo,
fetuses, man.
I got two guys, man. I can put you and put them in, and they're going to be my hitmen. I'm like, all right, let me know.
What's up?
Then they come walking in. I'm like, oh, I know them. What's up? Let's go. All right, so but at the end of the day, y'all introduce yourself.
Yeah,
you know
my name Man Gully, man. Philly born, man. Nice town. You know what I mean? Born and raised, man. Yo, shout out to the fam, man. Shout out to everybody, man. You know what I mean? Appreciate to be here.
I'm the boy Gutter. You know what I mean? Play muddy in that thing. You know what I'm saying?
Hey.
It's going to be crazy.
Say, tell them the nicknames you came up with, like in the movie, Say.
All right, so Gutter name is Muddy. And my name is Too Tall.
Come on, man. That's funny.
And we partners.
And they play their role very well. You feel what I'm saying? Yeah. Shout out to my sponsors. I got to definitely give a shout out to my sponsors.
Yes.
But most definitely, all the actors that came in the movie. My son is in the movie. I'm Maddie not here.
That's
Flawless. You know what I'm saying to you? Yeah. So
shout out to him. That's family love right there.
And my granddaughter in the movie. So,
hey,
like, right now, I'm thinking about it.
Say less.
But I look at this film as something that needed to be touched on. You feel what I'm saying to you?
I truly believe that.
Look what a Lord God has brought here.
Right.
You know what I'm saying to you? And I look at all these people. These are my peoples. You know what I'm saying to you? And they made my job easier. Yeah. Because when they show love to me, it's easy for me to make them look good and show love to them.
Right. Sure.
And I ain't had no problems with none of my people, so I love them all. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So shout out to Miss Porter. You know what I'm saying? She's not here today. You know what I'm saying to you? It's a lot of people that's not here today that would be celebrating this, you know what I mean, this interview, because us being here, man,
it's a moment.
It's meant to be. Sure. You know what I'm saying? That's the energy I got.
That's the energy I got. I'm so
good. I feel it. I feel it.
I didn't even set this interview up. Sandman did it. Shout out to Sandman.
Shout out to Sandman. Shout out to Sandman. Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, so.
You already know me.
My brother.
You already.
I'm going to bend down. So I'm Lucinda Trotter, also known as Philly Wonder Woman and the Bible Princess. Listen, I did something I would have never, ever, ever did in a million years.
What's that?
I cursed.
She cursed in the movie.
Yo, y'all don't understand. I'm like, you sure you want me to do that? Can I change the word? Other than that, everything was good. I'm like, well, my mom is going to see this. Like, y'all don't understand. Cursing was like a big deal, but I pulled it off.
Yeah.
Shout out to him.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because I believe in his project.
Heavy,
She killed the world, though.
Thank you.
She definitely do her thing.
I can't wait to see her movie, man. I can't wait to see the movie.
I seen her in a couple of other flicks, right? And I felt as though that the directors don't use her talent to their fullest. What they was doing was like giving her words to say, but not really coaching her through the actions. And I'm one to like really see the person and know what they can, their potential.
Yeah,
and then I try to push
bring
that
their potential to the maximum. You know what I mean?
I try to push that out. Yeah. So I was able to do that because I told her, I said, she was saying this one part. I was like, I don't believe that shit. Like, you got to do that.
He pulled it out of you, man. He pulled it out of you.
Listen, he pulled it out me. He pulled it out so much that people outside thought that this was a real argument between me and Craig McLaurin. And they was like, y'all, man, we go through the same thing at home.
That was a money shot right there.
Right. But you know what? I want to say one thing. You know how people don't think, they don't believe in the vision of someone else's? And like, if you're Tyler Perry, no matter what Tyler Perry going to do, you want to be in it? That's how I feel about him. No matter what he does, I want to be a part of it. Whether it's just to sell tickets, pass out flyers, whatever it is, I want to support him. I'm going to support him always.
I'm loving it.
It's the energy.
So, I want y'all to, everybody know who y'all are, and if y'all got Instagrams, whatever, I'm just shout it out. Let people know where they can find you, where they can see you.
Instagram, Bolo the Capo. Facebook.
Oh, I'm going to do mine real quick. BDC, I'm Philly Wonder Woman.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Do that one more time.
Yeah, Instagram, Bolo the Capo. Facebook, Bolo the Capo.
Okay. I'm going to say my name. My name is Kevin Savage. I go by Kevin Savage, but you call me Mister. Call me Mr. O. S-H-I-T. But you're going to find me on the stage. You're going to find me out there doing acting and doing comedy. You're going to see me everywhere, I promise.
Okay. All right.
Go ahead. Yeah, this is Main Gully. You can follow me at Facebook, Instagram, same thing. No underscores, nothing. Straight Main Gully.
Miss Megan Wilmore, but you can add me at Meglin1985. I'm on Instagram. It's Megan Wilmore on Facebook, but I do nonprofit work too. I always give back to the babies. Yes. I wanted to shout out my nonprofit, Model Mentoring. We are collecting old and new coats and sweaters and old and new toys for kids for December to give to the shelters in Philly.
Yes.
So, follow me.
Yes. Okay, I hope y'all heard that. Yes. Us giving back to the community.
It's Ben Gutter on IG and Facebook, engineer/songwriter. New studio will be up soon. Yeah, I mean, hit me up for that studio time and all that.
Okay.
Sandman, a.k.a. Sand Cannon. Underscore, Facebook, all that. But I just want to say, first of all, shout out to Gio for having us. You know what I'm saying? Because he definitely hit me, and I definitely, within 2 seconds, suggested bringing the cast.
Thanks.
And within 4 seconds, he said it's a go. You know what I mean? I want to thank my castmates, everybody who took it seriously enough to get it. Not saying that some people didn't, but I do appreciate every face here. You know what I'm saying? Because we're trying to get our point across.
Right.
I want to shout out EQ for being driven, consistent, thorough, and patient. You know what I mean? Because it's hard. I know it's hard. But you my bro. I'm the assistant director. Shout out to that. You know what I mean? You know what I'm saying? And then outside of that, man, just stay tuned. We working. Everybody in here individually are strong by themselves. We come together like Voltron. But everybody in here are Black Lion. That's real talk. So, you know. Stay tuned, man. We coming.
He in here with the lion on his back.
Right. Told him the lion came. Here we have. Told him lion came.
We working.
That
drip
is crazy over there. That drip is crazy. I see.
Thank you.
All right, you can. Mine is the Bible Princess or Philly Wonder Woman. You can follow me on either one. Facebook is Lucinda Trotter. I work with kids that's on house arrest. I have Jermaine all the time coming through, talking to these young people. So if you know anyone out here who would like to help me, help those young people, to steer them in a different direction than what they're going, please contact me. I need all the help. My hashtag is I can't do it by myself.
Real rap.
Got you. And you won't do it by yourself.
Amen. Right. Thank you.
That's your boy Jermaine Quick. Instagram, Jermaine Quick producer, Facebook, Jermaine Quick, and Twitter, EQ Philly. EQ Philly probably is going, that's what we started with, EQ Philly. So at the end of the day, that's always going to be the shot to go through. But first of all, I'd like to thank the cast for coming out. You know what I'm saying? Sam for hooking it up. But I need all of y'all there, man. Listen, this is
I'm
more
here.
Than, don't just support me as an individual. Support everybody as a cast, as a crew. But support the notion of mental illness.
So the premiere of the movie is December 5th.
December 5th, 69th Street, movie Studio Grill.
53 South 69th Street, Studio Movie Grill.
And how much are the tickets?
$15. We have two shows at 7 and two shows at 9.
Two shows at 7.
And if you press, you come in for free at 4.
But you got to contact.
You got to register.
If that means reach out to EQ.
You better register as press, so everybody, yep. You can't just slide through and just talk about yep. your press.
Yeah,
we don't do that.
Yeah,
we on business time. That's why I told you got to dress up.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I can dig it. Thursday, December 5th, you said it's a show at 7 p.m.?
Two shows at 7, two shows at 9.
PM, two shows
actually,
at 9
three PM. Shows at 7, three shows at 9. I'm sorry, go ahead.
Shows at 9 p.m.
Yeah, we did get another room. I just want to see how everything going to bubble.
All right. Listen.
Red carpet at what time?
I'm ready.
Red carpet is in between each time. The red carpet is 6:30 for the 7 o'clock show, and then 4:30 for the 5 o'clock show. It's only two walkthroughs.
Say that again.
Red carpet. We have 4:30 red carpet for the press and media, and then we have a 6:30 red carpet for all the.
I won't be able to get there around that time, but the earliest I can do is the 9 o'clock shows. You got three running at 9 o'clock?
9 o'clock.
All right.
The tickets are $15 still.
They go anytime. They go for anytime.
General mission, bro. General $15. Yeah. Listen, at the end of the day, I could have charged $20, but what I'm understanding about economics is that at the end of the day, when you do a $20 movie premiere, I'm asking kids to come out. I'm asking young kids.
Right.
So if you get paid this week, and you only got $100 to spend, you're not going to spend $40 or $60 with three kids and only have $40 for the week. Yeah. But you'll spend the $15.
Yeah. You'll spend the $15.
Facts.
Yeah.
That's
facts. Hey, yo, shout out Dub.
Shout out to Nina Pico. She online. Go ahead, say something. Go ahead. We listening. Go ahead. What you got to say?
Hey, guys.
Hey, how you doing?
I was telling them to accept my request on their live.
Oh. I just had to start it over.
Which live are you on?
She went off live.
No, tell her I just started it over.
Started the live over, so we live again.
Come back.
Accept my request.
Accept the request on the live so you can talk, right?
Yeah,
she got a
question.
Yeah.
Okay. Gio, what's your host name?
Queen Love.
Queen Love. Queen Love.
Yeah.
Thorough. Did a good job.
Thank you.
That's what's up. All right.
Is she?
I guess so, because she hung up here. But anyway, look. Once again, I appreciate the energy. I appreciate all y'all coming out. But I appreciate you, bro.
I appreciate y'all. Hey, listen, we got about 25 minutes left. We chilling. I was going to play some songs.
I got it.
I'm going to play one song, and then we're going to bring
P&B
Chiz and Homie back in.
I got her.
We can chill for a minute.
Shout out P&B Chiz and Homie. That's family. Yes, Dan.
Here she goes. I got her.
Y'all ain't
got
to go nowhere. We gonna close it out right here like that. You know
hey,
I mean?
Queen.
Well, if that's the case, I'm going with the sitters go to do what the sitters do. That's backward, boy.
Hey,
I got her on live, y'all. I got her on live.
Who we got on live? Dub, what up? Who we got on live?
Can we hear you? Say it again.
I didn't talk about the soundtrack.
Ain't nothing. I'm about to do a song break. Hey, Sha.
We can't hear you. Say it again.
Sha, we gonna get into the She on the Team. We're gonna do a song break.
Go ahead.
I forgot to talk about the soundtrack.
She said she the lead role.
She's the lead role. What's your name again?
Nikki.
There's a lot of talking going on. Yeah, I can barely hear
you. We can barely hear you. She like the way I drip. I always make a scene. She in my top five. Shorty on the team. Shorty in the whip. Shorty on the team. Shorty by my side. Shorty on the team. Yeah. Shorty stay down. Shorty on the team. Yeah. She on the team. Yeah. She on the team. Rosé in the glass. Deuce on the table. Friends with benefits. But we don't do no labels. I used to run into her and speak out of respect. Now when we see each other, it ain't nothing but sex. She told me not to call her phone, just send her a text. She said she got a boyfriend, he cutting the checks. She shining like a Bezzy, I rock her like a Prezzy. I pump it like a Getty, she riding like a Chevy. I'm in the friend zone, that's all I used to hear. I'm in the end zone, while she doing cheers. When she acting petty, I just make her disappear. Steph Curry, I'ma shoot my shot from anywhere. She was on the side, but now she on the team. We started out as friends, till I got in between. She like the way I drip, I always make a scene. She in my top five, shorty on the team, yeah. Shorty in the whip, shorty on the team, yeah. Shorty by my side, shorty on the team, yeah. Shorty stay down, shorty on the team, yeah. She on the team, yeah, she on the team. We don't go out to movies, we don't go out to eat. We don't be out in public, we strictly on the sheets. I rip and run the streets, but not everyone I meet. Gonna end up being team, some things I'll never speak. I know that she a freak, I never say a peep. We fly out to Miami, we party like the Greek. Rentals with heated seats, TV's a must at least. She like the role play, so it's like a meet and greet. Cherish the time we spend, we know how much it meant. You'll always be my friend, until we meet again. We blowing like the wind, we young and reckless and we living life of sin, let's do it all again. She was on the side, but now she on the team. We started out as friends, till I got in between. She like the way I drip, I always make a scene. She in my top five, shorty on the team, yeah. Shorty in the whip, shorty on the team, yeah. Shorty by my side, shorty on the team, yeah. Shorty stay down, shorty on the team, yeah. She on the team, yeah. She was on the side, but now she on the team. We started out as friends, till I got in between. She like the way I drip, I always make a scene. She in my top five, shorty on the team, yeah. Shorty in the whip, shorty on the team, yeah. Shorty by my side, shorty on the team, yeah. Shorty stay down, shorty on the team, yeah. She on the team, yeah. That was She on the Team. We back, you know what I mean? Sitting with the folks. That's my single. I laid that at Quad Studios. That's the same studio that you know, Tupac and late great Biggie Smalls used to record at. That's the same studio Pac got shot at, actually, right at Times Square. Shout out to Quad Studios. They quality is on a beam. But on another note, bro, JQ,
yep.
I wanted to ask you about the soundtrack on the movie.
Alright, so right now. I wrote, direct, produced the movie, and I did the sound score. So yeah. I'm more than a triple threat. You know what I mean? When it comes to this game, I've been producing music, like I said, since 1995. Right. I used to work at Sigma Sound Studios. Yeah. I did some work in the studio engineering and stuff like that. I was in there when Roots was in there, did songs with Scott Storch and all that good shit. Right? So we took the sound. Every movie that I do a soundtrack for. And this one, we gathered a couple of artists. We got Sandman is on the soundtrack. Got a R&B singer named Naya. She's on the soundtrack.
Okay.
R&B singer named Kenny Black. He's on the soundtrack. a rapper named O Trav, okay, from West Philly. He's on the soundtrack. My son Ty Flawless, he on the soundtrack.
That's dope.
Yeah, yeah. And from there, another R&B artist named Onda. She's on the soundtrack. Her new single called Choosy.
Oh, yeah, I know her, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. She's on the soundtrack.
She has a nice voice. Shout out to everybody on the soundtrack.
Most definitely. She got a nice voice. She's definitely got a nice track. And the song goes right with the movie, too. So right. We got her on there. We got a sister, Keelana. She's on there. She got a nice track on there. The rest of the tracks that's on there is mine. You know what I'm saying? And I got good about 6-7 joints on there. So yeah, listen.
That's what I'm talking about.
You know,
about.
We do what we
Yo,
do.
You a workaholic. Yeah. I salute it. Yeah.
Definitely. Listen, if you can give the man 16 hours, you can give yourself 16 hours. And that's how I live my life every day. If I ain't at work, I'm working on my business.
Right.
You know what I'm saying to you? So it's, everybody got the same 24 hours in a day. I just use mine a little differently.
Yeah, I agree. I do the same. I can relate.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. But if I don't do this, then I can't bring their vision out too. You know what I'm saying to you? And my whole task is, if I'm going to help somebody, I got to put myself in a position of boss to make sure that happens. So at the end of the day, doing these movies, that helps them get that leverage that they probably normally wouldn't get just by doing hip-hop alone. Because the industry is flooded. We know that. Yes. Right. You know what I'm saying to you? And it's hard to get seen. Yeah. But if I put you in a movie, now you can sell that with your music.
Right, right.
Right. That's cool.
That's a bigger catalog than ever.
Exactly. The actors actually do other things, and you promote them in the movies by doing their records on your...
Same thing with an actor. Same thing with a model. What happens is... With a model, yeah, you might get your little social media buzz, maybe, whatever. But now they get to see you in action. So they can, and that's also considered legacy once again, because my movies go to Amazon Prime, it goes to Prime Major Networks, and that's there for life. And we are an IMBD affiliated, so basically at the end of the day, all my work gets noticed.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I got credits right now for Dancing on Air. My last movie, Change the Beat. American Bully is up there now. And this will be next. Right. And so at the end of the day,
building that catalog,
when you're building that legacy, people get to see that you really serious about your work.
Right.
And so at the end of the day, that's what I want. I want people to understand this is a real movement in Philly. It's been a long time since something like this has happened. Most people that get on in Philly with films or whatever, they move to LA and do whatever.
Right.
But I've learned how to stabilize my situation and get more Philly artists out there, whether you act, sing, or whatever you do.
Yeah, facts. That's dope. That's, I like the vision, and I respect the hustle. You know what I mean?
So I appreciate you.
So if there's any artists and actors out there that's want to be in your movies, or how would they get to you? Like, how do they do that?
I establish relationships. If you just coming at me to get in, it might be hard for you to reach me. Okay. It's not that I'm not accessible. It's right. Just that I already know what you're here for.
Right.
Well, if they hungry. If
hungry and building relationships is two different things.
Okay.
So do you feed every dog on the street that's hungry?
No. They would keep coming back.
Yeah, it's impossible.
It's impossible, right? But if you see that one dog and you know that dog watch out for you, look out for you, ready to die for you, or ready to eat another nigga before you,
right.
That's the dog you're going to look out for, ain't it?
Right.
So I'm not going to feed every hungry stray that's in the street. So, yes, I don't accept every artist or actor that come my way.
Right.
What I do is I weed them out by your fruit.
You have to.
The fruit you bear is how I read you. Right. So at the end of the day, if you show me love and we because I'm on a love, I ain't on no... argue with you and all of that, because life is too short.
Say it again.
You know what I'm saying to you? So at the end of the day, when my peoples come and they show me love, I'm looking out for them. That's the first person I'm calling. I'm like, yo, I got this part. You want to do this?
Yeah.
They either going to say, yeah, it's in my schedule, or no, it's not in my schedule. Right. But I'm calling them first.
Right.
You feel what I'm saying to you? Because I already established a relationship. Right. So everybody that's in my movie, I already got relationships with.
Right.
You know what I'm saying to you? It's not some new random person that I can't establish no relationship with or I can't get close to.
Right. Yeah.
Now, and if it is, they got a small part.
Right.
It ain't nothing major.
Ain't major.
You know what I'm saying? All the major parts are people that I established foreground with.
Right.
Everything else is, you know what I mean, secondary. You feel me?
So you put your whole family on the map.
And that's how I look at it.
And that's,
I've been, like I said, I did the DVD magazine
scene for like 7 years when DVDs was popping. I got to establish relationships through the filming and doing all that. You know what I mean? I done filmed every artist in almost across the world. Like, we talking about big names. I ain't talking about no little names. You go back and do your research, you'll see that I got Lupe Fiasco first, right out the back when he did Kick Push.
Yeah.
Trey Songz, we and him sitting on the couch before he even blew up the way he is right now.
Right.
Meek Mills, I was the first person to ever interview Meek Mills. I'm in his last video, We Ball.
Wow.
You know what I'm saying to you? So at the end of the day, the relationships I established with people is just because of the energy that I bring to the table.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I work with 100.3 The Beat with Kobe Cole and Izzo and all of them dudes filming. Yeah. I done filmed every actor, artist you could possibly name. But that was that side. Now we on this movie style.
Right.
And then with this movie, I feel as though that I can bring Philly to another level because there's no prospective person when it comes to movies.
Right.
You feel what I'm saying to you? You're not gonna say I'm not gonna watch a movie because my man watch a movie. Now, if I say I'm holding a rap concert, you'd be like, no, my man rap, I'm cool.
Yeah,
you know,
that's
goofy.
That's goofy, but that's how the mentality is.
Yeah, yeah.
But everybody will come see my movie because it's hard to make a movie.
Right.
It ain't an easy thing to do. Easy. You know what I'm saying? So people want to come just to see what the movie's about.
And especially, it's not just a movie because, you know, a lot of people shoot movies like Low Budget Jones, and you know, you're going to see it, I'm going to support my folks and all that. And then, but I already seen the quality, and it's on 1,000. So, and I seen the trailer that y'all had.
Yeah.
It's dope. I know a lot of actors that's in the movie.
Congratulations, I'm just loving this.
I gotta support it.
Listen, you know I mean? I appreciate you. We got picked for the Los Angeles Film Festival, not because they saw the movie, but because they saw the trailer.
Right, that's what I'm saying. The trailer
is on that's on the beam. You feel what I'm saying?
Yes,
so
salute to you for putting the Philly on the back.
Listen, I appreciate it. I'm just trying. I'm trying to stay in my lane and be humble and do what I need to do.
Yes.
But I'm trying to, I'm going to give you some math real quick.
Yeah.
Cardi B, Chance the Rapper, and T.I. did a show, right?
Mm-hmm.
Where they was giving away $250,000 for rappers to come together for 30 days, and they created this atmosphere where they had to battle each other. They wanted to see the best performer,
right?
Yeah.
In 30 days.
Wow.
Well, in 1 year, I created a soundtrack, 4 albums, a whole movie, bro.
A whole movie.
Right? You know what I'm saying to you? And solicited 45 actors to be in the film. And we having a premiere. And I ain't got the kind of bag that they was giving away.
They was giving away, yeah.
You feel what I'm saying to you? So imagine if they looked my way and gave me that bag.
Right.
You know what I can do with that? Dude, you know what? I would employ the whole city, bro. Because it's not about money, make money.
Exactly.
You feel what I'm saying to you?
Dropping jewels, y'all hear it. Dropping jewels.
You know what I'm saying to you? So at the end of the day, when you got that kind of leverage, you can make more moves.
You can do whatever you want to do.
Right.
You're shooting something. You know what I mean?
All I'm saying is, if y'all listening, Cardi, Chance, T.I., you could give me that quarter. I did way more than all them artists you put on, even though they was dope. Now, I ain't going to lie, them artists that they put on was dope. But
with
a fraction of the budget,
yeah.
I did twice. 3 triple times over that. Because you got to remember, I directed everything.
That's crazy.
You know what I'm saying?
Your patience is crazy.
Oh, my patience is lovely. Yeah, yeah. I don't get into drama because I'm a thinker. You know what I'm saying to you? We ain't got to go there.
Nope.
Because life is too short.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, I don't have to prove myself that I'm a tough boy. Like, you know what I'm saying? I'm 6'3", you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And I carry guns all day. But what that mean? It don't mean
nothing.
It don't mean nothing, bro.
Yeah, it don't mean nothing.
So I gotta learn. I had to learn how to show love. So my patience comes from love.
It's about showing love because you know you trying to do something, you trying to better yourself and the people around you. So there's no time for negativity.
No time.
No time to look.
It's like life is too short, bro. Life is too short, man. I don't. And one thing I don't do, I'm a man of my word. I can't curse on this, but I don't Jew people. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
I don't F people over.
Right.
You know what I'm saying to you?
Yeah.
So at the end of the day, if I tell you I'm going to do something, I'm going to do it. If I can't do it, I'm going to tell you I can't do it.
Right.
Exactly.
That's all I ask for.
Loyalty.
You know what I'm saying?
You know what I mean?
And that's where my integrity lies. You know what I'm saying to you? Like, if we having a conversation, we ain't going to go through, well, I'm going to promise you this and promise you that, and then don't live up to my promise. I'm going to say, well, I can't do it because, or I can do it, but we have to do it at this time. You feel me?
Right.
And that gives you a clear definition of how we run it.
I do a lot of business with a lot of different people, and that's all I be wanting when I do business.
Right.
Just let me know
if
you can. It's not a problem, but don't,
You know what I mean? You already know.
That's right. And that's how I keep my business.
I had a performance last night that I got a bag for, right? At the Turkey Fest, right?
All
right. Now, it was like the details in my situation were a little bit different than other people's situations. You know what I mean? So they got, in other words, I was promised something and somebody was promised something else. You right. know what I mean? But when we get there, certain things change, but it's all good because we communicate.
Right.
Never a bad vibe, great night. Never a bad vibe, great night. Things changed about three times. It was a great night. We had like five bottles, VIP,
hookers. He didn't go to sleep.
Turkey Fest. I didn't go to sleep.
I don't know how you stand it.
Hey, well, you know what? That's the energy. That's the energy. That's the vibe. You know what I'm saying? Like, sometimes I don't even go to sleep.
Yeah.
I don't.
I'm steady working. I love this. I love what I do. You know what I mean?
It's just the passion. If you got passion for what you do, you know what I'm saying to you, it's not, sleep ain't even in the foreground. You feel what I'm saying? So, like for me, shoot, I come home from work now. I just did 16 straight. It'd be like 9 o'clock in the morning I come home, right? Most people say you need to go to bed. Shit, it's already 9 o'clock. Nigga, I can't go to bed. Right. So now I'm back in the basement. You know what I mean? Yeah. Chopping it up, doing whatever. And then I got to, so at my job, I get a little leniency. We get to have a 2 hours break before we can come back in. You know what I'm saying? So basically, I spend my time working more. So I don't really, sometimes as long as I get a power nap, bro. If I can get a power nap, it's good money. You feel me? But if I, you know, it is what it is. Shit. I mean, we got to do what we got to do. We don't get to levels like this.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Not sleeping.
Nope, you don't.
You know what I'm saying? You don't get the levels like this sleeping.
Right, right, right. Especially when you love what you do.
Right.
And I can see that you love what you do.
I do, man. And I love the people that I work with.
And that's wonderful. I'm so happy that you're putting your foot on. That's crazy. And I mean, a lot of people don't even do that. They'll go to the outside and say, you know what, let me do a casting call and do all that. But you don't do that. You go right to the family.
Right.
Right to your people. You already know who's going to do something for you.
Right.
That's wonderful.
And that's the energy I like to keep around me, too. You know what I'm saying? Because they're going to watch out for me. You know what I'm saying? It's been a while since I was able to go out and get wasted.
Right.
You feel what I'm saying to you?
Yeah, because working.
Not just working. It's just the energy around you. You got to watch shit like that. You got to watch stuff like that. Your energy. The energy is all you have. You feel what I'm saying to you? And so when you alleviate it, you know what I mean? You decrease. You let that energy down. So you gotta have other energy around you that's looking out for you.
Yes.
You feel what I'm saying to you?
That's
and so if you ain't got no energy around you, that you can't go get drunk. So it was a long time. It took me a long time before I can go get a drink.
Right.
When I'm out. Other than that, I'm on some nerd stuff.
I feel you. You're right about that.
Yep.
Shout out to my team, man, because my team is always loyal.
Shout
my
out
team
to
is
the
always
team.
With me, man. The whole folks, man. Bridge Life, Vito, Bruno, Scoop,
yeah.
Queen, CC, everybody, the whole kid, Glockaway, EA, like the whole family, like everybody's
always
real.
You gotta have a team, though. You gotta have a team.
You know
that's
mean?
Love.
You gotta have somebody supporting you.
Yeah.
You know,
friend
you gotta
daddy.
Feel it. You gotta feel it.
Friend
and daddy. I feel it all here. All these people are supporting you, and you're supporting them. That's what we're saying.
And that's how I look at it. That's how I want to keep it forever. You know what I'm saying to you? Like if the love you give is the love you receive.
Yes. Yes.
And
so
that's
you pick and
once
out,
you realize
you
that,
back.
That's gonna make you want to give so much
yes.
more.
Right.
Yes.
Right.
That's
yes.
the point that I just crossed. Like that's you know what I mean. I'm dealing with a lot right now, but I'm getting older and I'm getting more mature, and that's what type of time I'm on right now. That's where I'm at right now.
Yep. I know killers that look at me and just gotta shake my hand, just because they understand that I'm not on that.
Yeah.
That's their lane. That's what they do.
Respect that.
But it's just it's a respect,
so much,
you know what I'm saying? Because I ain't no fraud. Like you can't be no fraud in this world, man. You gotta be treat people who they are. You know what I'm saying? Give them their space and be respectful of their space. You feel what I'm saying to you? And they gonna give you that love right back. And that's what I try to do. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I mean, I don't have any beefs with nobody.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying to you? And whoever got a beef with me don't know me.
Right.
Because if they know me, they gonna love me.
Whoever think they beefing with me, you're not. You're probably beefing with yourself because I don't have
that kind of problem.
You're beefing
problem.
With yourself.
You're
I
right.
promise you that.
Listen.
I don't got time for none of that.
Listen.
Life is too short. What you say?
It's too short.
Jules.
Yeah.
Jules.
It's too short. Listen, all I know is I'm thankful for the crew I got. I'm thankful for the people that I work with. You know what I mean? We're going to get into some more music. You know what I'm saying to you? Like, that's the next level for me. Like, Because at the end of the day, I was doing music for a long time. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And it took the movies in order for my music to get heard. Right.
Well, you gotta send us some tracks.
You know what I'm saying to you? Right, oh, well, he got a couple of tracks anyway. You know what I'm saying to you? Yeah, he got a couple of tracks from the soundtrack. So here this is.
We're gonna close out the show to one of them. I'm about to send it to You got it, Sean? All right. Not yet. We're going to close the show out with it. Not yet. We got 5 minutes.
I didn't even know you had tracks for it.
Oh, yeah. We got that. Yes, the soundtrack about to drop next week. Let me say this. You know what I mean? I was just waiting to, you know what I mean, bubble everything. But, yeah, we got the soundtrack to the movie Heartless. A lot of artists, like I said in the beginning, we talked about the artists that's on it.
Yep. Shout out to all of them.
That's dropping next week. You know what I'm saying? And we're going to have a video for that and everything like that, too.
That's dope.
I mean, I do all my trailers. See, listen.
So what you doing with the soundtrack? You putting it out?
Out.
So it's all original?
All original music.
Man, that's dope. That's awesome.
We don't do other people's beats. All original stuff.
Yeah, so that thing dropping everywhere.
Oh yeah, it's dropping everywhere. Every major platform. That's what we do.
If you're gonna do something, do it right. I'm talking about in general.
Right.
If you're gonna do something, do it right. Don't do it halfway when you know you can do it way better. Go for the gusto.
You know, I'm gonna give y'all one jewel for your listeners. I'm gonna give you one jewel for your listeners.
Jewels, we love them. Go ahead.
If you are an artist and you're putting your music out on iTunes, Amazon, or whatever, don't allow that to be your only stream of revenue, expecting the money that iTunes or Amazon give you back.
No,
there are three other things you need to know, and I'm just going to give you these jewels, and I'm going to step off because it's so much more to this game.
After you give you the jewels, I'm going to close out, and then we're going right into the soundtrack.
Yes. Okay, musicreport.com. It's how you receive your mechanical royalties, okay?
Right.
After you go to musicreport.com, you need to go to SoundScan. SoundScan to register your music so when it's played on the radio, anytime it's played on any radio station venue, you'll get charted for it, and they'll have to send that report to your ASCAP, BMI, or SASAC, whoever you with, and that's also another mechanical royalty.
Yep.
And then after you do SoundScan, you do Nelson BDS. And after you do your Nelson BDS, you have to sign up for all four of those websites. Don't just sign up for CD Baby or TuneCore and think they're going to take
care
of everything.
That's just a distribution.
I hope y'all listening.
That's why a lot of people in the music business got gagged back in the day because they didn't understand the business.
Yeah.
And so I wanted to share that with y'all because there's listeners on your show that's trying to put music out and wondering why they only getting pennies on the dollar.
Right.
It's because they don't have their mechanical royalty set up as well as their
performance rights
royalties set up. So at the end of the day, I just wanted to share that because nobody talks about this type of stuff.
I try to tell certain people, and they don't really grasp onto what I'm saying to them. So I just, hey, look, man, I'm trying to let you know something. Like, because I'm all good. I'm official around the board. I've been like that for years. You know what I mean? Shout out to Montana Black because he put me on a lot of game too.
Right.
You know what
with
I mean?
Montana Black, I got my Union 215 hat on because I support. But Montana been around as long as I have.
He's been talking about
this Union 215 when I used to record them 2005. He used to host shows down on 7th and Spring Garden. What was that damn club called? I forgot the name of the club, but he used to host shows down there, and he's always been talking about unifying the city and learning the business aspect of it. So he's true to his word, true to the game.
Montana's a good dude. We're going to get into the soundtrack. You know what I mean? It's a no filler show. We closed out. We had the whole cast, the Heartless movie, December 5th coming out. Shout out to PNB Chiz. Shout out to Hobby 4.
Most definitely.
You know what I mean? We're in the building. We're going to rock out to the song. What song we gonna rock out to for the soundtrack?
I don't know if he can do I'm Lit or I'm Species, either one, but they both on the soundtrack.
Okay, we gonna rock out to that.
I'm Lit.
You're doing an I'm Lit joint.
I'm Lit, boy.
It's you?
Blow the horn like Coltrane. Yeah, I'm on my soul train. On that. Trying to get a dollar. If you're not a hater, then you better follow. Genie in a bottle, pushing on the throttle. Conversation heavy, stories from the Bible. Didn't see me coming, now I'm on the chart. Got a lot of pain, got a lot of heart. Niggas
niggas want to know? I'ma get it popping in the club. This is how I do it, show love. Pad and a pen. Haters better take it on the chin. I'ma tell my story through the lens. Give it to the hood, sell it to the birds. Yeah, have you heard, nigga? Come about the blow, nigga. Come and check my show, nigga. This is what you know, nigga. How to get this dough, nigga. Block as a little G, fly guy. I had to hustle, so I had to move a muscle. Some of y'all still living in a bubble. I'm in here, man, y'all in trouble. Taking over and I do it kinda subtle. About to take you on a whole nother level. My other watch got diamonds in the bezel. Cause in the hood you gotta learn how to juggle. I remember just jumping in the puddle. Little youngins get acquainted with the metal. I'm in the hood where they throw a lot of pebbles. And that's the life when you're living in the ghetto. I'm a savage, get this lavish. Rappers nowadays be spitting that babbage. Check it out, I got that status. So fly, you cannot grab it. Poppy got the mango. Now you looking hard, but you still don't know my name, yo. Just a different angle. Try to play me, I'll beat your ass like Django. Pipe down, little dude. Slow down, you can't fast this food. I was hot way before the interlude. I got the music that'll put you in the mood. Walk a mile in my shoes. Then you get acquainted with the blues. Then you get accustomed to the oohs. Everybody hanging on your jewels. Mommy used to drink a lot of booze. Now I got a life that I choose. Some of y'all get real amused when the black man dead on the news.